Hey, what's going on, podcast viewers and listeners? This is Scott Beer Cole here with you. This is episode 20 of our BAOS podcast. Thank you for joining us. Today, I was just at the Gluten-Free Garage, which is a gluten-free festival here in Toronto, at Witchwood Barns, which is at Christie and St. Clair, FYI. What it is a gluten-free festival that features different baked goods and food, anywhere from savory to sweet. And they also have beauty products, makeup, anything gluten-free you can think of, they have at this event. It's an annual event put on in the spring. I was lucky enough to speak to the organizer of the event, RonniLyn Pustil. Really nice lady. She started this event because her daughter suffers from celiac disease and thought it would be a good idea to kind of put together a bunch of local vendors and kind of have an expose of gluten-free products. So it was really nice of her to have us there. We also got to speak to Judith from Glutenberg, which is a gluten-free beer that they were featuring at the Gluten-Free Garage. It was awesome. You'll hear more about that in the podcast. I won't get too much into it right now. First off, I mean, as we always do in all our podcasts, let's run that theme music. Are you a brew head? I'm a brew head. Are you a brew head? I'm a brew head. Y'all are brew heads? Yeah, we brew heads. So pour a glass of craft beer, we can do this. Are you a brew head? I'm a brew head. Are you a brew head? I'm a brew head. Y'all are brew heads? Yeah, we brew heads. So pour a glass of craft beer, we can do this. Yeah. Sweet beer music to my ears. It's a great song, it really is. That's why it's our theme song. As you can see, I guess, C's not here with me, so I'm rolling solo, but that's okay. Still having a good time drinking beer. That's what's up. That's what we're all about here at BAOS. First things first, let's get to our sponsors, the people who make this podcast happen. First off, Uncle Phil from BrewHeads, thebrewheads.com. He's a beer merchandise brand. He sells anything beer related you can think of. So he sells beer snifter glasses and beer bottle openers. He sells shirts and headbands and hats, a whole bunch of stuff. So check him out at thebrewheads.com. If you enter the promo code BAOS, you will receive 15% off any of your purchases. Next, we have our good friend Jason Kucharawi, which he's from Toronto Urban Adventures, and he does a couple cool tours throughout the city of Toronto. So if you live in Toronto or you happen to be visiting, I highly recommend checking him out. He does a tour, a beer tour, called Beer Makes History Better. So that's definitely one I haven't checked out. I hear good things. I want to check it out. So I'm going to come visit you, Jason, this summer. If you enter the promo code BrewHeads, plural, you'll receive 20% off any of the urban tours that Jason does. Thirdly, we have our homie Notion from Illnote Studios. He's a producer. He'll mix and master any audio file you have. So definitely check him out. If you mention our podcast, however you happen to get in touch with him, you will receive 15% off any of his services. So you can reach him, I believe, at www.highseasonco.com/illnote-studios. Otherwise, just Google Illnote Studios. He'll come up. You'll figure it out. So we had a great time at the Gluten-Free Garage. I got to talk to Ronnie, the organizer, and Judith from Glutenberg. So we sampled the Glutenberg Blonde. Only good things to say about it. Glutenberg Blonde is now available in the LCBO. Looking forward to seeing a bunch of the other beers from Glutenberg there. I believe they have an IPA, a wit, an American Pale Ale. So all of that is very exciting. So I just want to give a special thanks to both Judith and Ronnie for having us. And thank you guys. Thank you, listeners and watchers of our podcast. You're lovely. We love you. And can't wait to do this again. Scott Beer Cole out. Peace. Yeah, we brew heads. So pour a glass of craft beer. We can do this. Yeah. Hey, podcast listeners and viewers. It's Scott Beer Cole with you. Here with Ronnie from the Gluten-Free Garage. We're here at the Wishwood Garage in Toronto, Ontario, Canada. If you want to tell us a little bit about this event and how it came about and the vendors here.
So this is our fifth event. We started in 2012, was our first. Today we have over 70 vendors. All gluten-free and all safe for people with celiac. Everything from bagels to beer to pizza, poutine, pierogies, dumplings, tacos, chocolate.
Anything under the sun, we got you covered if you're gluten-free, gluten intolerant, or have celiac.
Exactly.
So we personally came here for the beer, but there are lots of other offerings here. Can you tell us a little bit about the beers that are here today?
Sure. So we have three beer companies here today. There's Schnitzer Brau. They're an imported beer, totally gluten-free. And the Healthy Wine Agent is here representing them. Then we have Glutenberg beer, which they came all the way from Montreal.
Shouts to Glutenberg. Thanks for coming out.
New in the LCBO, so we really were excited about them coming. And it's a fantastic beer. My husband is a big beer drinker, and he really likes it. And then we have Bard's, which is the number one gluten-free beer in Ontario. They're here as well.
Awesome. Are you yourself gluten intolerant or celiac?
I am not. Okay. My daughter has celiac.
Okay.
So that's how this whole thing got started. Unfortunately, she won't be drinking the beer. She's only 10.
But a few more years down the road, she'll be able to.
She is enjoying everything else.
Awesome. It's good to hear. So how long has this event been running for? And why did you choose this beautiful venue to have this event in?
This venue is our local farmers market takes place here. So that's where I got the idea to kind of model it after a farmers market. And that's where I got the idea for the name, the Gluten-Free Garage, because the garage, big garage doors open up. So this is our fifth time here at the Barns doing the event. And every time it gets a little bit bigger and we have a lot more of a range of products and food for everybody.
Awesome. Well, it's very busy here. It looks like it's a very successful event.
Thank you.
Do you have any social media that people can reach you at?
Absolutely. So we're on Instagram. That's where we're kind of the most prominent. It's at Gluten Free Garage. On Twitter, we are at GLU and then the number 10, Free Garage. And we're on Facebook as well. And our hashtag for today is hashtag GFG16.
GFG16, got it. Is this a traveling event or is it only in Toronto?
It's only in Toronto.
Awesome, so you got to come here to get it.
It's once a year.
Once a year.
And this is May 1st, it's Celiac Awareness Month.
Amazing.
So we're here kicking off Celiac Awareness Month.
Well, great, thank you, Ronnie, for having us here.
Thank you for
coming.
And
we're going to enjoy some food and drink.
Thank you so much.
See you later, guys.
Bye. So pour a glass of craft beer, we
can do this. Yeah. Hey, what's going on, guys? Scott Beer Cole here from Beer and Others. Coming here from Gluten Free Garage in Toronto, Ontario, Canada. I'm here with the lovely Judith from Glutenberg, which is a gluten-free beer from Montreal, Quebec. Lovely to see you. Lovely to meet you. Thank you for having us here.
Well, thank you for having me as well.
Awesome.
It's really nice to be here.
Do you want to tell us a little bit about yourself and your beer journey and how you became an employee for Glutenberg?
Yeah, actually, I got the job at Glutenberg right at the end of my degree. I studied in public relations in Montreal, and I was lucky enough to, you know, apply for the job. And out of 250 applicants, they chose me.
Nice.
And because they're a really young and thriving company, they're always looking for new blood and always looking for new opportunities and always looking for new ideas. They're very, you know, they're very creative. They have a very unique view. So they're always looking for young people to drive that that point of view.
Awesome. So what is Glutenberg's story? How did the beer come about? And why gluten-free? Why make a gluten-free beer?
Well, first of all, Glutenberg was born because of the two co-founders, actually, called Julien Niquet and David Caillé. Julien and David were both friends in university. They met in university. They became good friends. And Julien is a serial entrepreneur, honestly, too. And what happens is he's also celiac, and he was absolutely discouraged by the offer of gluten-free beers in the market. And with David, they just came up with the project when they decided to brew a gluten-free beer. So they teamed up, bought their home brewing kit, and decided to give it a try. And it was a disaster.
Of course, the first time always is, right?
Yeah, yeah. But apparently it was such a big mess. It was terrible. And that's when they decided to, you know, call in a master brewer who actually knew what he was doing. And they posted an offer on Facebook, and that's how they found the third co-founder, Gabriel Charbonneau, who is to this day still the master brewer at Glutenberg. And they spent over a year in research and development, and they came up with the recipe for the Glutenberg Blanc. And once they released it, it changed the whole game on the gluten-free market, especially in Quebec. Then they came up with the APA, which is the American Pale Ale. And then they also came up with the Red. And it all changed and boomed in 2012 when they subscribed to the World Beer Cup Awards in San Diego that year. And they won all three medals, so gold, silver, and bronze, in the best gluten-free beers category.
So what's different in the brewing process that makes a gluten-free beer? Is it different ingredients you're using? Is it a different process? What exactly is the process that makes it gluten-free?
Well, it all starts in the ingredients, you know? We know that a couple of breweries use what we call a gluten process, a gluten removal process.
Right.
And what we do not do, and we do not intend to ever do here at Glutenberg, is use that. What we do is we use 100% certified gluten-free ingredients, starting from the grain. So as you can see on the can here, it says that it's millet and corn beer. So we use three main grains in our regular series, which are millet, buckwheat, and corn. And for the other styles, as well as the white or the red, we also use grains such as amaranth, quinoa, etc.
Okay, so you're not a gluten-reduced beer, you're a gluten-free beer. So this is okay for people with celiac disease. Anyone with a gluten intolerance can drink this beer and not have any adverse effects.
Absolutely. I would say that it's the best option for celiacs out there. As our slogan states, it's 100% gluten-free and 100% great taste.
Okay, awesome. So you are available now in the... I know you're available in Montreal, but you are now available in the LCBO as of recently. What beer do we have? What beer options do we have in the LCBO?
Yes, it's very exciting to be available at the LCBO. Unfortunately, it starts out just with the Blonde. I say unfortunately, but it's fortunate for people, because people have been asking for it for a long time. But right now, it's only the Blonde that is available at the LCBO. It's available in over 160 stores, and the list just keeps growing. Just have to check out the LCBO website to see where it's sold. And if it's not available, just request it, and they usually order it.
Okay, perfect. So you do have more than just the Blonde, though. You have a few offerings, I noticed here.
Yeah, absolutely.
As it's soaking wet, it is raining out here, so
yeah.
I mean, we're fighting the elements, but there's beer, so we're here.
Good thing it's laminated, though.
Yes, exactly. So we have the Blonde, we have a American Pale Ale, which is the red one,
yep.
A Blanc, and then we have a Red and an India Pale Ale. So you do have quite a, you know, broad spectrum of gluten-free beers. It's not just your one classic Blonde or Lager or Pilsner. You do have some darker beers, some hoppier beers.
Absolutely.
Will these eventually become available in the LCBO? Hopefully, possibly.
We're working really hard to have them listed. We can't confirm a specific date, but we can tell you that we are working really hard to have them listed in the LCBO, as well as the beer store.
Okay.
And we're also working to have them available in bars and restaurants within the next year.
Okay, awesome.
So we're definitely working really hard, because as you can see, our regular series offers a very wide range of products and a wide range of styles also. The IPA is one of our biggest sellers because it is very, very hoppy, and the APA is hoppy but very balanced with the citrusy aromas. And one of our latest achievements actually is the white, which is white belt. It's called... The white is usually brewed with wheat. And the style is called a wheat beer.
Yes.
We gave it our own twist by brewing it with quinoa and amaranth,
okay,
and adding coriander and peels. So it's a very, very refreshing beer with a dry finale, and it's our latest achievement. And we're really
so like a classic white style beer.
Absolutely.
Without
but
any of the. That's amazing.
Yeah.
So you mentioned there's you use quinoa,
yep,
millet, and what was the other?
Amaranth.
Amaranth,
and
okay.
Buckwheat.
Okay.
Amaranth is for the whites. Buckwheat is for pretty much the whole series.
And as well corn, I believe you said. And
yep.
Yeah. I noticed a lot of other gluten-free beers use sorghum. Do you use any sorghum in any of your beers?
Is that a sugary agent?
Yes, yes.
We use candy syrup, which is a beet syrup.
Okay, cool.
So it's no added...
Like Belgian candy syrup?
I think it's German.
German,
I'm not
okay,
sure.
Cool.
I would have to check on that, so don't take my word for it. But it's all natural syrup, made from beets.
Okay, awesome. Also, we're a big fan of BAOS here at Beer and Others.
Yeah.
So you have some ties to BAOS on here?
Yes, we do, actually. Well, out of Glutenberg came another company called Transbrew.
Okay.
Transbrew. And we're a company specialized in distributing microbreweries here in Quebec,
okay,
actually. But BAOS came to Quebec and chose Transbrew to have their distribution, and they also linked up with Gluten-Berg and they became our agent here in Ontario.
Okay, awesome.
So I know that it's pretty new for them and it's pretty new for us as well, so we're still working out the parameters of that arrangement, but so far it's been nothing but good stuff. Honestly, the people are at BAOS are so cool and they work hard. They manage to be both cool and laid back and hardworking at the same time, you know?
So they lend themselves very well to your company, Glutenberg. Well, not your
Absolutely.
Company, the company you work for, Glutenberg, with the same philosophies, laid back, chill.
Absolutely.
Cool. Awesome.
Well, we work really hard as well, and
of course.
Just like BAOS does. So yeah, but it's been nothing but good stuff with them so far.
Well, I want to continue talking about beer, but I also want to try this beer because this is kind of what we do. Drink, we talk. This is how it works here at Beer and Under.
Crack up a fresh one. Then.
Awesome. So this is the blonde we're having. This is the one that is available in the LCBO.
So here you go.
Lovely, thank you. That looks lovely. Another thing, so preparing for this interview, I went out and had to try a few gluten-free beers.
Yeah.
I wasn't very familiar. I had tried a few in the past, but not a wide variety of them. One thing I noticed about a lot of the other beers were they didn't pour the same way a classic beer would, meaning there wasn't a nice head on it. It didn't pour really. It didn't seem very carbonated. Whereas this beer, you just poured that right now, and you can see that right there, guys. There's a nice big fluffy white head on the top of it. So is that something you guys do different than others, or is that just the brewing process that you put it through?
Well, actually it's everything and much more than that, actually, because what we do at Glutenberg is not only do we brew gluten-free beer, but first and foremost we also brew excellent beer. We put a lot of energy into making good beer aside from just making it gluten-free. Some would even say that aside from just being a gluten-free beer, it's just a good beer that happens to be gluten-free. So yeah, definitely we put a lot of effort into
that. Cheers. Let's try it.
Verdict?
That's lovely. Yeah, it's it's light and crisp and refreshing. Well carbonated. It's sweet. It has like a nice sweet undertone there, like almost like an apple or pear crispness to it. It still tastes like beer. It's beer. I mean, it's minus the gluten, I guess.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's lovely. That's really nice, actually.
I'm glad that you like it.
Yeah. So recently you got a few favorable write-ups in some local newspapers.
Absolutely.
Namely the Globe and Mail and the Toronto Star.
I know, I have them right here.
Oh, of course, she comes prepared.
Yeah, absolutely.
So tell us a little bit about what they thought of your beer. What they thought about your beer.
Oh, actually, it's very interesting because the Toronto Star tested five other beers, a total of five beers, gluten-free beers currently available at the LCBO, and they stated that Glutenberg was the best of the bunch, stating that, you know, taste-wise and body-wise, just like you said, it came as close to a real beer as it can get.
Nice.
Or at least, they said that we were the best of the bunch, and it was definitely worth the detour, and it was
nice.
A great solution for celiacs over the summer, and not only for celiacs, but also for beer enthusiasts.
Okay, cool. So, as myself, I'm a beer enthusiast.
Exactly, so am I. So the Toronto Star was a really great review. As for the Globe and Mail, this is absolutely great because funny story, the wife of the Ben Johnson, who is the author of the article, is also celiac, and he had been looking for a good gluten-free for a while. So when we reached out to him and to tell him that we were coming to Ontario and that we would be sent, and if he wanted a sample, he said yes right away. And out of it came a wonderful article that stated that, in Canada, I don't know if I've stated this before, but we can't technically be called a beer. We have to be a millet beer or a millet and corn beer because
right.
we do not use any malt
of course.
In our brewing process.
Sure.
But that's just a play on word, you know, because we still brew with the regular...
the same process and
exactly.
all the other ingredients as other than the malt, right?
Exactly, exactly. And what Mr. Ben Johnson said in his article... I'm sorry. What Mr. Ben Johnson said in his article was that he explained what the law was, and then he said that Glutenberg was as close to real beer as it came. So honestly, it's going to brighten up your summer. But if it's better than this.
Yes.
Yeah.
Sorry if people are walking by here. It's a very busy event, so there's
people
walking all over the place. We're trying to block them as we can, but sorry if there's any interruptions, guys. Another thing I want to talk about, I checked on your website.
Yeah.
And you have a series gastronomy. Sorry if I butchered the term cities gastronomy.
Well, in French, it's série gastronomie.
Like she said.
But partnership with François Chartier, which is a world-renowned sommelier. We've been working with him for over 2 years. The series started in 2014, actually. Okay. And what we do with him is that we work with him and elaborate beers that can be paired with meals.
Okay.
And we get one beer for every season. And so far, we have a lot of success. Yeah.
Well, yeah, I saw the lineup and it looked just amazing. Like you had some ice beers, some cask aged beers. There was one with chestnuts in it. Like, yeah, you're just using different ingredients to make a good craft beer. And I'll call it beer because that's what it tastes like. It doesn't taste like it's a gluten free beer. No, it tastes like a beer I'd like to drink on a patio or, you know, at a bar or anywhere. So
yeah.
It's really cool to see someone who's taking gluten-free and kind of bringing it to a whole nother level, right? Like adding flavors that aren't usually associated with beer. Because a lot of people associate gluten-free beer with kind of this bland, flavorless, just something for people who, you know, can't enjoy beer to have. But it's more than that. It's for beer lovers as well. It's for people that just enjoy good craft beer. So
I'm very glad to hear you say that, because that's what we're aiming to do, actually. Aside from brewing gluten-free beer, we also aspire to, you know, entice beer geeks and let them know that not only do we respect the styles, but we look forward to developing them as well. We're a very daring company, and we have a lot of big projects on the line, and we try to entice the beer geeks as much as possible.
Awesome.
Honestly, yeah.
So do you guys have any further aspirations to bring your beer, well, around Canada, around the world, specifically Ontario?
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, Ontario has been the one province where we were not distributing it to date. So we started out 2016 with the kick, and distribution started in Ontario around Mars. Mars. Not the planet.
On the planet Mars, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Reaching for the stars.
Yes,
you know,
of course. Oh, wow. Okay, that's a good analogy.
Yeah, right. Nice save there. Yeah. We started distributing at the LCBO around March, and we're working to have all the other styles listed or available in bars and restaurants within the next year. We cannot make any promises as to when will that happen, although we consider we're working really hard to have other styles as well as the blonde listed.
Okay.
Because right now we are available in Alberta, Saskatchewan, Manitoba. We're also available in BC, and Glutenberg is also sold in 20 states in United States, such as Virginia, Delaware, Massachusetts, New York, South California. And
everywhere, basically, except for Ontario. So why did it take so long to get to Ontario? Is that because of our rigid liquor laws here, or?
Well, yeah, partly because of the rigid regular liquor laws, because, you know, everything has to. Wow. Okay. So there's
my thank you.
Thanks to the.
We're in the middle of a tornado here.
Yeah. But we really want to give you the beer, so
yes,
we're still here.
So we're still here.
Thank you, guys. It's so nice of you.
Thank you.
So we have Palmy Cider right beside us, and we have Country Boy City Crafted Brickworks right beside us.
We got some ciders here.
They're giving us a hand with our banner. They're so nice. So yeah, what were we saying? Yeah, okay, the liquor laws. Yeah. Well, the LCBO is a very particular, you know, company, let's say, to work with, because it's government regulated. So obviously, it always takes a bit more time to get things moving. And I think that's mainly why it took so much time, because people have been asking for it for a very long time, honestly.
Awesome. Well, do you have some social media that people can get in touch with Glutenberg or find out where they can find it?
Absolutely. So we are on Facebook. Just look for us under Glutenberg. We're also on Instagram on Glutenberg Beer. And we're also on Twitter at Glutenberg. And you can just reach out to us anytime. And if you would like to see where Glutenberg is available, just check out the LCBO websites. Type in Glutenberg and you'll see a list of all the stores where it's available right now. The list keeps growing. So hopefully with your help, guys, it's going to grow even longer now.
Awesome. Well, thanks so much, guys, for listening and watching. This is Scott Beer Cole signing off. Thank you, Judith, so much.
Thank you, Scott. I'm so glad I could meet you, and it was really nice.
Likewise. I can enjoy some beer now, guys. Peace.
Bye.